there's an idea to be shared just for 30 seconds. Can you guess a person who had just one cubicle room with only three friends to work with him, just least amount, maybe less than 100,000 to start with, just idea was the only asset he had, and then he started to think that I can make a good company. I can go for a corporate client. I can go for a very private limited corporate company in Pakistan. The very idea was based on his own personal skills. Can you name that company? Anybody? He deserves the third prize actually, but we will not give him. He's right, it's Rosie.com. I have the honor to invite Mr. Monas Rahman. He is the Chief Executive Officer of Rosie.com Pakistan. He is a wonderful initiator in Pakistani corporate industry, bringing such a wonderful instrument to give a platform where people can get their rosies. Please join your hands together to welcome the very honorable guest of the moment, Mr. Monas Rahman. He'll be sharing his success with all of you.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. I would first like to thank the organizers of this event, and specifically for the most wonderful introduction. I think that's the best introduction I've ever had, and it's really heartfelt. Before I begin, I want to understand a little bit more about you, the people in the chairs. So I'm going to start with some very easy questions. It's a bit of an IQ test as well. So pehla jo sawal hai, how many of you are male? Oh my goodness. Okay, so about 80% of the men are not aware of their gender. This is a big problem when you hunt for jobs, kyunki employers expect you know your gender. I'm going to ask one more time. How many of you are male? Abhi bhi kafi confusion hai. Okay. Let's try the other half, the better half. How many of you are female? Very good. Everybody knows that they're female if they're female. How many of you are currently students? Enrolled? Acha. Okay. How many of you were students within the last 6 months? TK. How many of you are currently looking for a job, actively looking for a job? Takriban sare. All right. That helps me understand what I'm going to talk about. And what I'm going to talk to you about today, I think will be useful, because ab yahan par hame 2003 se we've been operating in Pakistan. Takriban 7-8 saal ho gaye hain aur employment industry mein acha khasa experience hai. Today rosie.pk is used by about 34,000 companies. It's a big number for Pakistan. Inme se huge employers bhi shamil hain. Thank you. Huge employers bhi hain aapke. You have the Coca-Cola, you have MCB Bank, United Nations, Bank Al Falah, Engro. Magar isme se bahut se small employers bhi included. About 39,000 very, very small employers who you probably have not heard of. Rosie.pk 2010 mein, it was used by about 1/4 of the internet population of Pakistan. 1/4. 25% of all the people in Pakistan who have internet access visited rosie.pk, which shows ke improving employment opportunities is very important to the people of the country. And it also shows that the age group of internet users is such that career is very, very important. So through the years, I've seen a lot of trends, have seen a lot of people applying for jobs, a lot of people with broken hearts, and a lot of people who have done fantastic throughout their experience inside the employment network. So how does finding a job start? Where does the whole process start from? Anybody? Who can tell me? And one thing I'm going to tell you, the people who get the best jobs and move up the career ladders are not the people who are shy. I promise you that. I've seen that over and over again. So don't be shy. This is going to kill your career. So who can tell me, where does your job hunt process start? What is the beginning? Ji, please. Job search, that's part of the process. It doesn't begin there. Acha, aap batai ji. Self-evaluation, excellent answer. Okay, Aisha, please. In your mind, okay, all very, very good answers. So let's talk a little bit more tactically. First of all, you have to groom yourself for the job market, right? And all of you have done that. Aapne matlab, you have obtained educational opportunities, you have done a degree, you're studying, you are gaining knowledge, you are improving yourself so that you have skills that can be valuable in the workforce. Good start. And one of the things I hear over and over again, and I think it's very unfair, employers always ask, what do you want to do? I don't know, maine accounting ki degree ki hai, econ ki degree ki hai. I don't know exactly, I can do marketing, main sales bhi kar sakta hu, I can even do a call center job. Nahi nahi, but tell me what you want to do. You're confused. And I think it's very unfair. It's unfair because when I was a student, I'm not that old, about mid-20s mein hu approximately, plus or minus few years. When I was a student, I was very confused. I didn't know what I wanted to do. Theek hai, engineering ki degrees to ki thi maine. I was interested in engineering, but I didn't know what was out there, what roles actually meant. In my mind, the job of an electrical engineer as a student was not the job of the electrical engineer who had worked 10 years. It was a different profession, and I had no way of knowing that. So first of all, relax. If you don't know exactly what you want to do, don't stress. Relax. Nobody does. It's okay. But what is important is that you have the attitude, you have the initiative, and the desire to explore and find out ki aapke jo talents hain, both built-in talents, jo Allah mein ne aapko diye, your natural talents, combined with the skill set you have acquired through education and work, how do you maximize that? What is the right opportunity for you? And ye evolving cheez hai ji. Abhi jo aapki opportunities hain, they're not the same opportunities that you will be most valuable for 5 years from now or 8 years from now. And you have to constantly reevaluate yourself and find out, where are my strengths? Where can I add the most value? And when I talk to you about value, ye bhi bahut important cheez hai. I want you to put yourself in a different seat. Aap to is seat pe baithe, put yourself in that chair. Jo interview aapke saath ho raha hai, wo jo banda hai, why is he talking to you? Why is he interested in you? Anybody? Please. Somebody. Ji in the back. Aap bataye. Why is he interviewing you?
He want to check your experience. He want to check your skills. How much you know about this, any organization requirements. That's why we came here.
Okay. He is interviewing you. He wants to evaluate you. Theek baat hai. But why is he spending his time? He doesn't need to evaluate people. That's not his job. Why has he invited you? Ji, please.
To find that if that particular person can bring himself up to the requirement of his organization.
That's a much better answer. Anybody else? Is side se bataye. Ji mujhe, please.
Usne apni puri zindagi apne kaam ko di hai. He has devoted his life to his work. That's why he is interviewing on that seat.
Theek hai. That's also right. But mujhe bataye ki ek banda hai. He is spending days of his time talking to people who he doesn't know and interviewing them. Why is he interviewing? Why? What's the motivation? He's not there to test people. That's not his end goal. End goal kya hai uska? I want to hear from a female, because I think females are a lot smarter than males. Is side se mujhe, please.
Definitely wo apna time isliye spend kar raha hai taki wo apni organization ke andar kuch talent leke aaye aur kuch value addition ho us naye bande se.
Excellent answer. That's the best answer so far. So you also said that. This is a gender bias. You're probably right. He's interviewing to bring talent into the organization so he can build value into the organization, so the company can do better, the company can grow, and company can make more profits. Very simple. To achieve the objectives of the company, he is trying to acquire talent. Iska matlab ye hai ki aapki jo value hai, aapki jo ahmiyat hai uske samne, bahut simple hai. It's simply, what can you do for me? I give you a salary, but you better be able to give me more value back than the money I'm paying you. Otherwise, why would I pay you? And be very clear on this. Your success as a professional and throughout your career is going to be based on how much you are giving back to the corporation, how much value you're creating, and how you're helping achieve their objectives. So understand the other side, because then it's easy to complain, ki ji, main to gaya tha, har cheez mere paas hai, I have a degree, ye hai, wo, and they offered me 8,000 rupees. Why did they offer you 8,000 rupees? What's your value? Is this the right job for you? Okay. With that kind of introduction, when you start your initial grooming, you have education, and you start to explore the job process, what is the first thing you do? This is a tactical question. What do? You create a CV. You create a CV. Okay. CVs do not get you jobs. Aaj tak it hasn't been the case ki aapne CV di, aapko employment offer aa gaya. Is saath se CV di, usne kaha wah bhai ye le. Employment offer, your salary. Is tarah nahi hota. But is tarah zarur hota hai ki aapne CV di, usne kaha no thank you. So a CV is a filter. It helps employers quickly figure out ki ye banda sahi nahi hai. And it lets employers figure out ki isme potential hai, isko zara invite karte hain, interview karte hain, isse milte hain zara. The CV is very important because it is your entry ticket. Aap log idhar aaye hue hain, you're going to speak to employers in the job fair. Aapka jo CV hoga, uske basis pe log kahenge, isko is pile mein rakhein ya is pile mein rakhein. Ye wala jo pile hai na, this is going back with me into my office. Aur ye wala pile jo hai, you'll find it in a dustbin after they leave. Make sure your CV is in the correct pile. How do you do that? A CV has to show why I should hire you. Isme do elements aate hain. Ek element to ye hai ki aapke kya abilities hain, what skill sets you have. You have to highlight the best and strongest points about you, and this means being creative. And you have to highlight that in a very professional way. You could be a fantastic person, excellent skills and experience hai aapka. You give me a lousy CV, maine dekha, maine aapko is pile mein rakh diya, aapke chances khatam ho gaye. First element, highlight your strengths. Show yourself in the best possible light. And that's what everybody was talking about. Aapki jo grooming hai, the clothing you wear, the colors. The idea is to show yourself in the best possible light. Dusri jo baat hoti hai CV mein, jo I think bahut ignore hoti hai. You have to show yourself in the best possible light based on the opportunity that the employer wants. Agar job sales ki job hai, aur aapne CV pe you put ke ji, I had this experience, I did this kind of project, ye kiya, but it has no relation to the job at hand, you're not attractive to me. Jo aapka experience hai, try to customize it based on the job so it's interesting. Achha, is bande ka sales ka experience hai, ya sales mein interest hai, sales mein he has a project. You might not want to mention that sales project for a different kind of job. So try to cater your strength based on the opportunity. The biggest problem that you'll have, and I promise you'll have this, and you've probably already experienced this. Aap logon ke paas abhi experience nahi hai. You are relatively inexperienced. Jahan bhi aap jayenge, wo kahenge, yaar, aapke paas so experience nahi hai. Ek aur banda, he has 8 years of experience, 3 years of experience. He knows this work. Usko pata hai, he has a job in X and Y company. They do the same thing. And he wants about your salary a little bit more. Isko main job dunga. How can you compete? Because practical experience is very important. Hota hai. Jo school mein aapki cheeze hain, in the workforce, it's just a different world. So what I am going to urge you to do, and I'm talking from experience, this isn't just an idea. You have to get a taste of practical experience. You give me 2 CVs, same background, same projects, GPA, but one of them has done an internship for 3 months at a company whose name I recognize. That's interesting. No doubt I will lean towards him. He knows what a professional environment is like. Somebody else found him attractive enough. Har cheez mein, it's a sales, right? You're trying to sell yourself to a company. Sales mein, number one rule is, create demand and scarcity. If nobody wants to hire you, why should I hire you? But if other people found you attractive, koi hogi aap mein baat. So I urge you all to get experience, do internships. And people say, yaar, internships nahi mil rahi. If you know what you want to do, you know I want a banking career. You know you want to work in the IT sector. You know you want to work for a big accounting company. You should do everything you can to get a job in the kind of company you would like to work. Put it on your CV. Because then other companies like that will value it. Don't worry about money. This is not the time for you to worry about your salary. I know, when you go home, parents, friends ask you, yaar, aapki, what's your salary? It's a matter of pride to say that I'm being paid this much money. And you might be embarrassed to say that you're being paid this much money. Abhi uski na fikr kare. Pehle 3-4 saal jo hai na aapke, get the right experience at the right kind of company. You can cash in on it many fold later on in your career. So how do you get that internship? And this is where I'm saying, do not be shy. If you are shy and you wait for people to say, aap aa jaye, I have a job for you. Bahut rare hota hai. You have to stand up and say, hire me. Hire me because I can bring value to your organization. I can bring disproportionate value. Yani ki jitna aap mujhe de rahe hain, usse zyada aapko main, I'll give you back. That's interesting to me as an employer because I'm going to have a profit. Profit either in terms of things I can do as an organization or profit in terms of how much I can make as an organization. So do internships for free. 3 mahine kaam kar le. It's the best investment you will ever make. Offer an employer, main free mein aapke saath, I will work with you. I want to learn. I will do anything you tell me. 3 mahine unke saath spend karein. Best investment you'll make in your career. There isn't a culture of internships in Pakistan. You need to force that. And very few employers will say no to you if you have passion, wo jo spark in the eye and a fire in the belly, bahut important baat ki thi. You go to an employer, you say, I want to help you. I'm not interested in any money. Let me help you for free. Show yourself in your best light. 3 mahine udhar kaam kare. There's a chance that he will hire you himself after 3 months. But you have to be aggressive because is market mein, it's very difficult to find a job. Don't just wait ke inshallah application maine di inshallah ho jayega kuch na kuch. Apne haath mein le cheezon ko. So internships extremely important. Dusra fayda ye hota hai ki aapka jo CV hai, bahut se aise you've got CVs jo completely blank hote hain. Aapka naam likha aata hai, school aata hai, you have a GPA aata hai bas. Aur kya likhu yaar isme? CV empty hai, English mistakes aapne ki hui hain, grammar mistakes ki hui hain, formatting is off. Which pile will I put your CV in? Right or left? Left. How do you make your CV stronger? Internship ki jo maine abhi aapse ki hai baat, you put that internship on your CV. You put your projects that are relevant to the job on your CV. You do it creatively. You can use words. You can say, I'm an exceptional individual. I value results. I create results. I am a self-starter. What does an employer want to hear? They want to see that confidence. Don't be shy. If I ask you, aapke strength kya hai, ji, main to bas, you know. No, stand up and tell me in a loud, confident voice, what are your strengths? So once you create that CV, the next step is to start the job hunt. What is the best way to find job opportunities? Anybody? Rosie.pk? No. What's the best way? Absolutely not. Anybody else? Market scanning? Okay, a bit further. Gigi? Contact HR department? TK? But not quite. Yes, who said that? Please stand up. A round of applause for this person. Internationally, please sit down. Everywhere in the world, the best way to find a job is through people you already know. Okay, the personal connections, and I'm not talking about a sifarish. I'm talking about a network. You know somebody who knows another person. You have a friend who's already employed in the organization. They have an opening. You tell your friend, I'm interested. He goes directly to the HR head who he knows personally. He says, this is a friend of mine. He's very bright. Aapka CV pile ke upar chala jayega. Trust. People employ based on trust. If they have somebody credible vouching for you ki ye banda theek hai, he's smart, he doesn't lie, he has integrity, he has energy, I know him. It's worth a lot to me. What's the next best way to find the job opportunities? I heard the answer before. Rosie.pk, thank you. There are a lot of jobs posted on Rosie. About 100 new jobs are posted per week. Bahut se jobs hain. You can look at newspapers as well. Newspapers have jobs. You can talk to HR heads and find out what jobs they have. But newspaper and jobs on the internet, ek baat usme, you have to realize, and don't get frustrated, kyunki bahut frustrating process hota hai. Log kehte hai ki ji, maine to I applied for 20 jobs, ek bhi call nahi aayi mujhe. Kyun nahi aapko call aayi? There's something wrong with me. Realize that when you apply for a job, shayad ek opening hai. Ek job opening hai. I want a sales engineer, a manager for sales. Ek maine job posting ki, maine akhbar mein dali, I put it on the internet. How many CVs do I get? Anybody? Andaza lagaye. Thousands? Hundreds? Thousands? Itne CVs aayenge. Aur mujhe ek bande ko rakhna hai. First ko dekha, second, third, fourth, fifth. Eighth wala jo hai, ye banda zara sahi lag raha hai, usko maine hire kar liya. What happens to the other 9,990? Gaye, wo sare frustrate ho jayenge. So understand that it is a highly competitive job market. And that's why everything I've said, how to make yourself stand out, is very, very important. You must make yourself stand out from the crowd. And iski abhi aur bhi, I know we've heard a lot on that. Once you explore opportunities, you get a phone call, it's like a lottery ticket. Interview ke liye aa jaye. This is your chance. This is your chance to get in. And if you are unprofessional or not prepared for the interview, you will not be able to avail that opportunity. Interview ki achhi khasi idhar hui hain baatein, we've already heard. But I want to take two people. Who's brave? Who's going to be a volunteer for me? Ajay, please. Ek aur. Any female who's brave enough to come on stage? Anybody? Nobody. Now, this is a cultural problem. You're going to compete with these people who aren't afraid. Do you really want a job or are you just exploring? Anybody? Last chance for a female to be a volunteer. I won't be mean, I promise. I'll be very nice. Ajay, please. Thank you. A round of applause. This is bravery. And believe me, if you want to work, you can't be shy. You cannot afford to be shy. Achha, first thing I'd like ke aap introduce kare apne aapko. Just briefly, apna naam bataye. And
Anam Kabir. I completed my MBA from Virtual University of Pakistan. A dual specialization, management and human resource management.
I am Tariq Zubair. I am assistant professor of English here in Lahore.
Theek hai. So I have shortlisted both of you. Aapke CVs bhi maine dekhe hain. Aap logon ko maine invite bhi kiya hai ki aa jaye. I'm interested. Your CV passed the filter. It went in the right side pile, not the left side pile. Meaning ke you are up for consideration. Ab aapko bhi nahi janta, aapko bhi nahi janta. Now I'm going to interview and I'm going to ask you a few basic questions and I'm going to work with you. The idea is to help, not just you, but everybody else, on what the right way to handle the interviewer is. Toh pehla ye sawal hai, very direct. Why should I hire you? Aapko main kyun hire karu? Open-ended question hai. Kya matlab mujhe kyun hire kar rahe hai? Why should I hire you? How should I answer? But this is a question that you should be prepared for. Why should I hire you? Aap bataye mujhe.
पहले तो जो क्राइटेरिया है जॉब डिस्क्रिप्शन का, मैं उस पर कहूँगी कि आई एम एमबीए स्टूडेंट. इफ़ यू आर हायरिंग फॉर एचआर डिपार्टमेंट, तो मैंने एचआर स्पेशलाइजेशन किया है. सेकंडली, मेरी जो स्किल्स हैं उनको मैं उनको एवेल्यूएट कर बताऊँगी कि मेरी ये स्किल्स हैं. सेकेंडली किस तरह से ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डिपार्टमेंट में अगर मैं उसके लिए सीख कर रही हूँ किस तरह से मैनेज कर सकते हैं, इसमें कॉन्फ्लिक्ट मैनेजमेंट को मैं इनको डिस्क्राइब करूँ, हाउ आई विल मैनेज द एम्प्लॉयज इफ अ कॉन्फ्लिक्ट अराइजेस, और उसके बाद फाइल मैनेजमेंट हाउ आई विल डू दैट। तो मतलब फर्स्टली यही होगा कि मैं अपनी स्किल्स को उनको बताऊँ, सेकेंडली अपने किस तरह से उनके मैं वैल्यू ऐड कर सकती हूँ उनकी कंपनी में, क्योंकि एम्प्लॉय सबसे होते हैं, उनको मैनेज करेंगे तो जाहिर बात है वो आगे से अपने स्किल्स के जरिए कंपनी को हाई लेवल पे ले जा सकते हैं।
ओके ग्रेट एक्सेलेंट, आप बताएं व्हाई शुड आई हायर यू?
बिकॉज दिस इज द प्रोफेशन वेयर आई फाउंड माई सेल्फ द बेस्ट प्लेइंग एंड बीइंग अ पर्सन हु टेक्स इनिशिएटिव एंड आल्सो goes beyond the expectations of the employer, I found myself the best possible person for this job.
Excellent. Okay, great. So, isme do cheeze hain that you should keep in mind. Ek to you have to make sure that you're qualified for the job. And you are qualified if you've invited for an interview. Agar aap idhar tak aa chuke hain, iska matlab hai you're qualified. So you have to say, I'm very qualified for this. I have all of the skill sets you need. But that's not enough. Kyunki bahut se log hain. Everybody who's coming in for my interview today is qualified. Otherwise, they wouldn't be here. So telling me that you're qualified for the position is not raising a bell in my mind ki ye banda sahi hai. Of course, you're qualified. Otherwise, I wouldn't have invited you here. That's a minimum criteria. You must be qualified. The other thing is, how badly do you want this job? Are you really interested? Ki bas aise, is this a time pass for you? Or do you really want to show your passion for the field, for the company, and for the position? There's a beautiful thing that we heard earlier. The spark in the eye, fire in the belly. This is what makes interviews succeed. Show that passion, which you have shown. Which you have shown. Excellent. Abhinay, I still have a few more questions for you. Third thing, aapne karni hai, you have to make sure that the employer understands you know their business and you know the company. Don't ever go to an interview without researching the company. What is their business? What do they do? What are some significant events jo unke saath abhi hue? You should know this. And you should throw it into the interview because that shows that you're interested, that you're engaged, that you've taken the time to research, that you have initiative. So incorporate that into these answers. Not only am I very qualified for your position, but I'm very passionate about sales. I've done a lot of research in sales and my senior project was on sales. And I know what your company is going through. You've seen exceptional growth in the consumer area. And that's an area that I understand very well. And I think I could help you grow in that field. I'm the best person for this job. Is it arrogant? You should lean towards arrogance as opposed to humility. Humility, you don't get points in the interview for humility. There are other places to be humble, not in the interview. Bold and emphasize your strength. Okay. First question, make sure you get that right. Don't yawn. Don't look down. Eye contact. Seedha dekhe, aankhon mein dekhe. Look in the eyes. Speak confidently. Have a smile on your face. Be assertive. Very important. If you're talking to me and you look down, maine GHR mein kuch kiya hai, or I understand, I have skills. Not interested yet. I've got 50 other people who are coming for this interview. Distinguish yourself. The next question I'm going to ask, I want to see how you respond. And then I'll tell you how I think you should respond. Tell me your biggest weakness. What is your biggest weakness?
My biggest weakness is that I need a little bit of this initiate level pe direction. Then I mean, जबरदस्त आई थिंक के मैं कर सकती हूँ उसके बाद कंप्लीट टास्क।
ओके तो इनिशिएटिव की मतलब आई नीड टू स्पेंड मोर टाइम विद यू। अच्छा ओके ओके आई एम जोकिंग।
बाय नेचर आई एम ए परफेक्शनिस्ट एंड समटाइम्स बीइंग परफेक्शनिस्ट हैम्पर्स मी फ्रॉम फाइंडिंग पीपल हु आर अप टू द मार्क।
मच ओके एक्सेलेंट। तो व्हेन समबडी इज आस्किंग योर वीकनेस don't lie. Everybody has weaknesses. We have a lot of weaknesses. But agar aap kahe kabhi kabhi main jhoot bolta hu, meri kamzori, I'm sorry, mind na kare, main kabhi kabhi main I lie a little bit. That might be a very honest answer, but that's not the answer you should be giving. Everybody has weaknesses. You have to convert the question into a strength. Take the opportunity. You have to show your weakness as a strength. What's your weakness? It was a good answer. I'm a perfectionist. I like to see everything done perfectly. And at times, it's an issue because not everybody else has that same standard. But I adjust to it. It's okay. But that's my weakness. I'm a perfectionist. Yourself out. I'd like to thank you very much. A round of applause, please. Thank you. Acha. Once you go through that interview process, ho sakta hai ke do teen interviews aapke aur hain uske baad, they ask you more questions. Go through it. We talked a lot about dress. Wear a pink shirt, don't wear a red shirt, wear white socks, wear blue socks, wear green socks. It's very confusing. Aap jo hain, you could all go in wearing a pink shirt and black socks. And apne baal bhi aapne achhi tarah se matlab kiye hue hain, you've showered, you smell good. Aap jaye aur aapko job na mile. Sab kuch to maine theek kiya tha yaar. I wore the pink shirt bhi pehni thi, shoes bhi pehne the, black socks. To kya ho gaya? Appearance. You have to show your best side. Best side in terms of your skills, your initiative, your passion, your attitude, and your appearance. And in some jobs, appearance is more important than others. Don't fight it. Apni na beech mein dale ke main to bas I wear jeans. Main to sneakers pehnta hoon. I'm only in suits always. I only wear suits. Main shalwar kameez hi pehnta hoon bas. National dress hai mera. This is not the right attitude when you're going for employment. You have to be flexible. You have to understand the customer. You have to model your appearance based on the customer. And when you're in the interview, your customer is that company. When you're in sales and you go and see a client, you should dress and talk the way the customer is. Because people like people who are like them. People like people who are similar to them. If I'm in a bank and everybody else is wearing a suit, and you're not wearing a suit, you're not similar to me, you're standing out, I'm going to notice it, and it's going to interfere with the business we have to transact. So don't fight against it. Be flexible. Model your behavior, your skills, the way you talk to your client, to the company. And if you don't show that flexibility, there's an attitude issue that will hit you. Don't be stubborn. You're too young to be stubborn right now. Do that when you're about to leave your company. Then say, bas aise hi hoga. Abhi na kare. So, you go through this process, aapka interview bhi ho jata hai, everything goes good, aur aapko phir offer aati hai. Aur offer ka jo process hai, this is a little tricky. Because wo phir izzat ka thoda sa ho jata hai baat. Offer kya mili hai, job title kya hai aapka, what is a company name? And this very easily can get you sidetracked. Ki yaar offer itni achhi nahi thi. Ya role jo de rahe, it's not a senior role, it's a junior role. Mujhe to ye job title chahiye. The company is good. First job, do not evaluate on the basis of salary. You will make a mistake, I promise you. If you try to get the highest salary, ye mujhe 15 offer kar rahe, ye mujhe 12 offer kar rahe the. ये मुझे 22 ऑफर कर रहे हैं 22 ऑफर कर रहे हैं वाह यार उधर जाओ इट्स अ कॉल सेंटर जॉब यू गो यू पे 22 हो सकता है द जॉब दैट वाज ऑफरिंग यू 12 यू वुड गेट सच गुड स्किल्स कि विद इन टू इयर्स यू'ड बी मेकिंग 50 और कॉल सेंटर की जॉब में हो सकता है कि तीन साल बाद यू आर 23 आप अंदर तो चले गए कि यार इतनी सैलरी थी क्या बात है. So look at your long-term objective, look at your growth, sacrifice your salary for the first 3 years. Sacrifice it. I'm not saying it's not important, it's important. But it should be one of the last factors to consider in your job in your first 3 years. Get the right experience at the right company. Learn, improve yourself. Because at the end of the day, people who are successful are the ones who can give the most value back to their companies. I said this earlier too. And how do you give more value back? It's by learning. There's no shortcut. You can't just put stamps on your CVs. Ye stamp bhi hai, toh ye stamp bhi hai, is company ka stamp, and now I should get 80,000 rupees. You might get that first job, you won't stay in the company. The way to move up the career ladder is to improve yourself, get the best experience, to learn, and to be able to bring value back to the company. No shortcuts. be the best. And all of you have the potential to be the best. Throughout your careers, once you get the job, once you accept it, once you do a negotiation for the salary, you start working, align your personal tasks with the objectives of the company. Aap andar jaate hain, you don't understand ki what the company does. Aapko pata hai ki ji, mera kaam jo hai, ye jo aa rahi hain forms, inko idhar input karta hun, I make a printout, aur phir Altaf sahab ko deta hun. Ye mera kaam hai. You might do a good job all day, idhar se form le enter ki Altaf sahab ko dete gaye, Altaf sahab usko stamp karte gaye. But you don't understand ki wo jo forms hain, those are application forms in an insurance company, for example. Aur wo jo process hai aapka, Altaf sahab ke baad udhar jata hai, phir udhar jata hai, phir idhar jata hai, it's costing the company money because it's inefficient. And if you step back and say, mera kaam to ye hai ki idhar se idhar doon, phir ye karte hain, phir wo karte hain, phir idhar jata hai, is tarah kyon kar rahe hain? Why don't we just do it ki main isko phir idhar enter karun and it goes directly to this department, udhar ye bhi karein, and so instead of 1 week, it can take 3 days. Question it. Bring value back. Go and talk to the management. Say, hum is tarah kyon kar rahe hain? I can do it faster and better. Why? Because it will result in more profit for the company. But the only way you can analyze that is to understand what the company does and what tasks you can do to align with the success of the company. If you don't understand that, then you will be a robot in the company, and 8 saal baad, you'll slowly move up your ladder. So align yourself with the business, understand the business, align yourself with the success, and be exceptional, always. I wish you all the luck in your career. Thank you very much. Are there any questions? Koi hai sawal aapke hain? I think we have a Q&A. Any questions, I'd be happy to answer. Ji, please.
Sir, my name is Mohammed Zubair, and I would like to ask, how would you place the role of luck and destiny in job search?
Bada achha sawal poocha hai aapne. And for those who get disheartened, I think luck has such a major, major role. Right time, applying to the right job, HR head, us waqt udhar the, aapka CV unki mez pe pahuncha hai, usi waqt opportunity thi. Right place, right time. Luck has a lot to do with your career success, always. The head of your group has left for any reason, opportunity create ho gayi, there's nobody else in the organization, you're the only one, aapko dal diya. Luck, right place, right time. So luck has a lot to do with it. Magar luck aapke haath mein nahi hai. It might be in the hands of your mother, who can pray for you. Please urge her to pray for you. But you have to create your own luck. The people who succeed are the ones who create their own luck. You say, he was lucky. He was here at the right time. He was there at the right time. But you'll find that there are people who are more adept to luck than others. And when I say create your own luck, I mean it for all spheres of your life. Apna luck khud create kare. How do you create luck? It's by being prepared for opportunity. Okay, abhi, if there's an opportunity, I'm in the right place. I have made sure that everything I have is prepared ki agar ye opportunity aati hai, I can maximize on it. And throughout my career, it's important. Create your own luck. Ji, please.
I want to add something over here. So when I started my career, somebody told me that luck is basically an acronym, and it stands for labor under correct knowledge.
Thank you, that's beautiful. Thank you. Ji, please, in the back, Iftikhar.
Assalamu alaikum. My name is Iftikhar Hussain. I'm from University of Central Punjab. Munas, is it necessary for successful businessmen you have to do a job first, then you have to set up your own startup?
Ye bhi bada acha sawal pucha hai. Entrepreneurship ka iska matlab hai. This is linked to entrepreneurship. Bahut si stories hain ki ji, drop out of college, start a company, become a billionaire. Bahut se examples bhi hain aise. Magar aap just consider ki wo jo examples hai na, people who succeed, they stand out because they're so exceptional. They're such a minority. For all of the people who drop out, for all of the people who start a company directly after school without any experience and succeed, the probability of success, wohi hamari ho rahi thi baat, luck. Probability of success is very low. I'm not saying ki nahi ho sakta. Ho sakta aur hua hai. But it's like winning a lottery ticket. So how do you create your own luck? How do you maximize? How do you increase the probability for success? If you're interested in starting a business and you want to be successful, the best way is to equip yourself with the knowledge and skills in that business. Understand the mechanics. Who are the suppliers? Who do you buy from? What are the seasonalities of the business? How do you do a management of the supply chain? Ye cheezein aap school mein nahi seekhte. And you can learn over 3-4 years, make your mistakes, lose your money. But why? Why don't you work for a company that's in that business? Learn their best practices. Learn how to think, learn how to strategize. Get that knowledge, learn the contacts. Who are the people in this who are going to help me? Who are the suppliers? Get knowledge, equip yourself. That way, when now you go and start that same business, you have learned on the bill of the people who do it best. You've learned the best practices, you understand the environment, then start your own business, and I guarantee you the probability of success is going to be 10 times more than if you had started right out of school with no experience.
Well, my name is Wajahat Ali Khan and I'm from UMT, University of Management Technology. I have a question that if somebody is not completed his degree formally, then why every company asks for the formal degree that he or she should have the MBA, he should have the BBA honors? If somebody is good in, as an intellectual, he has done so many things in the market, then why should company ask for the formal degrees?
Bahut acha sawal hai. Again, just a brilliant question.
Thank you. One
issue I have, frankly, because I'm also an entrepreneur, I think out of the box and I value results. A lot of large corporations have very defined ki GPA at least itna hona chahiye. Hum in 3 schools se hire karte hain. Hamara jo evaluation test hai, ispe exactly itne number hone chahiye. He didn't come in with a suit on, he came in with white socks on, isko nikalo. And I don't believe that's the best way to assess talent. But you see, when you're in a large organization, efficiency gets sacrificed because itne applicants aapke paas aa rahe hain har saal. 2000 applicants ko ji aapko interview karna hai, evaluate karna hai. So then you have a factory kind of evaluation process. Idhar se idhar tap 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 karke theek hai isko hire karo. So understand this. It's not right, but that's the way large organizations operate at times. Some HR groups have a vision and they won't operate that way, but others are just doing their job. Kyunki agar is bande ko maine job de di aur aage jaake koi issue hua to log kahenge yaar isko kyun hire kiya, he didn't even have a degree, GPA to low thi. Hamari organization mein I don't even look at where they graduated from, what the GPA was, or even what the degree was. Honestly, on the JD we say ki we want a person with XYZ. And we've hired people who haven't even graduated, who are now at senior roles in the company because they are exceptional, exceptional people. And you will miss that exceptional talent. But you are operating in a world that's not fair. You can't change the world. You can't. You're not in a position to. Try to change the world, but don't expect ki bas aise hi hoga, I'm right, aise hi hoga. You have to adopt yourself to the realities of the world. Ji, please.
Sir, my name is Ibadat Khan. I belong to Gilgit. My question is that during an interview, employer usually ask applicant, what is the expectation of your salary? So what is the best answer to give at that time? Because we don't know the, what is the requirement, exactly the allocation of the salary. If I say 30,000, while the position is for like 15,000 rupees. So
there are two ways to answer this question. I'm going to tell you what I would do, which is a little non-conventional, and the HR experts and professionals here may not agree with what I'm going to tell you. One way to answer the person is to tell them what you expect. So if you really want a job for 30,000, you say, I want 35,000. I'll say 35,000, you'll say 25, beech mein jaake ho jayega na 30. That's one way to do it. But you can easily jeopardize the entire hiring process by being too clever or being too aggressive with the salary. And first thing you need to do is realize, as your first job, salary is not the most important thing. Iski already ho chuki hai baat. It's the last of your things. So don't lose this opportunity because the salaries didn't match. You want to maximize it, but don't make them close the door on you. Any successful kind of negotiation, the trick, it's a dance that you do. The trick is to get the other person to first indicate a number to you. So if he says, how much salary do you expect? You say, look, I'm flexible. How much does this job offer? Let them put the first stake in the ground. Because if your initial stake is here, it's too high. Idhar aa gaya, it's too low. You're biasing it. If you say, I expect 12,000, but he had in mind 30,000. Yeah, 12,000? I'll tell you what, I'll give you 13,000. Sahi? Main aa gaya. But if he tells you between 20 to 30, now let me readjust. And let me ask for 33,000. I know he's willing to pay 20 to 30. Now I might get 25 or 26. So this is a negotiation. You want to do it with integrity, with honesty, but you don't want it to, one, leave a bad taste in the employer's mouth. If you're over smart, over aggressive, people will just write you off. Yeah, iska attitude theek nahi. I don't want to work with this guy. He's greedy, etc., etc. So don't be overly aggressive. Don't have the door closed on you. Get them to nominate a number first and then reasonably do a negotiation. And understand that salary is not your objective right now. Your objective is the right job at the right place and the right experience.
Gigi. My name is Moin Akhtar, student of MBA Marketing in Comsys Institute of Information Technology. So you told us about that we must have to get the experience of about 4 to 5 years as a practical field, whether we are going to start our own business. So I want to add here that we are the student of MBA and business, and we have lots of knowledge in our books which we read. So that is really helpful to us to get the knowledge whatever we are going to do and how that can be applied, because that is also not the illiterate person who put that knowledge in the books. They are also very much illiterate person and much successful businessmen who are there, about whom the philosophy we read. And I think the lots of market research can be put according to the business which we want to start. Much of the information can be get from the people who are actually doing those by interviewing them and getting the knowledge from them.
ठीक है, तो आपकी point भी valid है कि education में 4 साल आपने लगाए, 8 साल लगाए, 3 साल लगाए, हर रोज you're going to classes, doing homework, it's not worth zero, you're getting knowledge, you're working very hard, आपकी बात ठीक है, but let me tell you, I did graduate work from Stanford in electrical engineering. I did undergraduate work. Spent 8 years, best institutions, bahut study kiya hai, to research kiya hai. Jitna wo knowledge maine job mein istemal kiya hai, maybe 5%, honestly. So, humble yourself. You do not know anything. Assume that. Aapne padhai ki hai, aapke grades bhi acche aaye hain. You have done excellent in your accounting class, in your mathematics class. But once you're behind the desk, now you need to apply knowledge, and more importantly, gain new knowledge and apply it to the business, which no school can train you for. This is work experience. That's why I'm saying internship. Ek cheez jo bahut important hai, school education ka kya fayda hai? Agar only 5% of what you're learning you can directly apply in the job market, to fayda kya hua iska? Why even do it? Fayda aapka ye hua. Okay, education gives your mind the ability to learn in a structured and in a way that you can grow more. All of the classes you're doing are teaching you to learn in the right way and gain knowledge. And that ability to learn, acquire information, to process it, regardless of what that information is, that is the most valuable thing that you will walk out with when you graduate. So that is your asset, is the ability to learn. But don't be fooled into thinking everything I learned, acha khasa maine kiya hai, I can add a lot of value on day one. The real world does not align with the academic world in most cases, unfortunately. I think ek aakhri sawal hum le le. Ji, please.
Ji, please. This is Bilal. I'm a CRO, currently working in Telenor. And what if I ask in...
Ab kya karte hain, sorry?
CRO.
Acha, theek.
Specifically, इस कॉल सेंटर इंडस्ट्री में कोई आपसे नया एम्प्लॉयर पूछता है, would you want to leave the previous employer? तो उसका स्पेसिफिक गुड आंसर क्या है? अगर मैं आंसर देता हूँ कोई बैड इफेक्ट्स देता हूँ पिछली कंपनी के जो रियलिटी बेसिस पे है, अगर मैं अपने गुड पॉइंट्स पे आऊँ कि मैं सच बोल रहा हूँ और मैं इस कंपनी से इसमें ये बैड इफेक्ट्स हैं, मैं आपकी गुड कंपनी में गुड फैक्ट्स दे के इसलिए आया हूँ।
अगेन वेरी आपका बहुत अच्छा सवाल, वेरी ट्रिकी क्वेश्चन, एंड आई थिंक दिस इज वन क्वेश्चन दैट अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल डू नॉट आंसर करेक्टली और दे गेट पुट इनटू द लेफ्ट पाइल। तो सवाल ये है कि why are you leaving your company, why do you want to leave your company and join a new company, or why did you leave your last company? First thing is ki you have to understand why he's asking that question. Aap se wo sawal kyon puch raha hai? Usko dar hai ki aap aa jaye, he makes you an offer, aapko 6 mahine usne khoob train kiya, he hasn't gotten anything from you, 6 months later aap keh rahe I have a new offer at this company, it's paying more, uska to sara times aaya ho gaya, phir interview kare and he's lost the opportunity. So employers will not hire you if they see a track record of you leaving every year. Har saal ji joins a new company, har 8 mahine he's new company. That CV, no matter how qualified you are, it's not worth the investment, because it shows there's a very good chance ki after 6 months you're going to leave my company. I don't care how good you are, 6 months is not enough for me to get enough value, I'm going to reject you. So understand that first. They're looking for stability. They're looking for somebody who can perform. Call center industry mein haqeeqat ye hai ki turnover sabse high. It's the highest turnover out of all of the jobs. Because there are few roles in the call center industry to allow you to rise after 5-6 years. The number of people who are going to get those roles gets very, very small relative to the number of people in the industry. So the turnover is high. People are expecting a turnover that's high. But they want to make sure that if they treat you fairly and well and reasonably, you won't always have an itch ki abhi mujhe new job karni hai. So the right way to answer that question is to have a very good reason that I saw no growth opportunity at this company. I had worked there for 3 years. I was at the same role. I didn't learn anything new. And this is the best thing you can say, because I wasn't learning. It's the most noble answer. Nobody can say, okay, you weren't learning, to kya hua? Acha, you weren't learning, that's why you left. Kya baat hai? He wants to learn. I wasn't learning, I wasn't growing. And I think that's the right way to answer that question. But thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Mones.
Thank you very much.
I am very thankful to Mones Rehman. He always collaborates with Superior University in our all events. And he is the main collaborator, you can see, in our all places. Please give him a big hand. You all are here because of other advertisement, but the major area of our advertisement of this event is rosie.pk. Now I would like to invite Dr. Irfan Amir, Dean Management Sciences, to present the souvenir on behalf of Superior University. Thank you very much.